Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be on how to make an HTV vinyl shirt, which is this one that I'm wearing right now. It has all of the reindeers on it. I'll try to back up if you guys can see it. And the shirt came out super cute. I think this is such a cute shirt to make, especially for the holidays, or if you want to make it as a gift, or if you want to just wear it yourself around the house. Out of focus. I'm really excited about this tutorial and I cannot wait to show you guys how to make it. So let's get into it. First, you're going to want to open up Cricut Design Space and start typing up the names of each reindeer. I put the and sign after each reindeer except for Vixen because that's how the song goes. This is totally customizable to your liking though. Next, we're going to find the font called Neothic, which is the bolded font that I use to create that modern look. For some odd reason, the and sign wasn't working with this font, so I just found a font that looks similar to Neothic and adjusted the sizing. So then I went ahead and I removed the weird symbol off of each one and carefully aligned the and sign with the words and then grouped all of it once I was finished. To make it easier, I changed the color to white since this is the color vinyl that I'll be using. And then save it when you're done just so we have our work saved. And then once you make it to your liking, you're gonna click weld and then make it. I cannot stress enough that it is so important to click mirror on when working with HTV vinyl. I have made the mistake before and have wasted so much vinyl by overlooking the mirror button. Write down the size of the design so you can cut your vinyl appropriately and then click continue. Now you can set your Cricut to iron on. I usually do iron on plus so it cuts deeper and is easier to weed. And I highly suggest to invest in a small cutting board like this to make it easier to cut your vinyl, especially there are no lines on the back of HTV vinyl unlike Oracle 651 vinyl. Firmly press the vinyl with the shiny side down on your Cricut mat, or use a roller which I asked for Christmas, and then double check to make sure you have your Cricut adjusted to the right setting. Feed it into your Cricut and press the arrow button and then the Cricut logo button to start cutting. Once it's at 100%, you're done and can remove your vinyl from the mat. And then you'll be able to start weeding, which is my favorite part. So when weeding this project, you're going to want to remove the background and the inside of each letter that has a center, such as A's, O's, R's, etc. I like to weed the inside of each letter before removing the background vinyl just so it's a little bit easier to pull apart. Once you're finished, you can finally start heat pressing. I always like to see where I'm going to put my design before I preheat it, just so I can get an idea of where to place the design. Then as my heat press is warming up, I will use it to remove any moisture and wrinkles from the shirt so it gives the vinyl a clean surface to work with. This shirt is extremely wrinkly and the vinyl must adhere to a flat surface, so it's super important to not skip this step. Now I'll readjust where I'm placing the design, and once you like where the design is, take your Teflon sheet and heat press. With C's or Easy Weed, your Cricut should be at 305 degrees and set for 10 to 15 seconds. I usually do 15 seconds and do it about 2 times to make sure it adheres to the shirt. Then, after I do that, I will flip the shirt and heat the back of the shirt. This is a tip that Cricut recommends to help vinyl adhere better. I will lightly go over it one more time without the Teflon sheet to ensure that the design is firmly on the shirt. Then, I take off the carrier sheet to reveal the final design. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, please put it in the comment section below and tell me what you think of the shirt. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!